sad heaven with grief. We give God praise because the Hebrew boys cried out in the fiery furnace. Our God is still able. In spite of and regardless of what we're dealing with on today, our God is a very present help in the time of trouble. The question is asked, where was God in all of this? He was right there.
Amen.
He still kept his word that I'll never leave you nor will I forsake you, but I will be with you always, even in death, to the end of this age.
Amen.
And today we come leaning on his everlasting arm. The old saints say, I'm leaning safe and secure from all harm. And so today, God, we lift up and celebrate. I see you today in this celebration of life. Enter into the service with a musical selection, You Will Love by Whitney Houston. And that will be followed by a prayer by Michael Kelly, Sid's grandfather. Will you please come in that order? Innocent. his testimony is over. He returns to the glory of your kingdom. For such a child had to come from you. Father, comfort the hearts of all that are here, especially his parents, for they filled his cup with flowers. You tell us, Lord God, to lean not into our own understanding, but to acknowledge you. Well, we know, Father, that you are Alpha and Omega. We know that you're the way out of no way. We know, Father, that you are our guide in the darkness. And we know that you will comfort this family. Watch over my children, Father. Keep them, Lord. Let them know that this is not the end for your baby. This is only the beginning. In the name of your son, Christ Jesus, we say, amen. Many times it's our travels to that distant place called morning time that we need God. The old song says, I need thee, O Lord, I need thee. Every hour I need thee, oh, bless me now. And it's my prayer to this father, this mother, this family, that God bless you now. Tomorrow we'll work itself out, but now we need a now faith blessing in this place today. And we never have the right words ever in a time like this, but he said, Paul says, it's not enticing words of men's wisdom that we get strength. He said, power and demonstration of the Holy Spirit. And we ask today as we celebrate this life that the Holy Spirit answer questions that we can't answer, fill in gaps that we cannot fill, heal what we cannot heal, and touch what we cannot touch. And so, Father, we summon your presence in this place as we come now for the affirmation reading. Breath's sweet holy rock, a name of Kelly and Kristen Wright. Will you please come? Thank you.
Those who have died, who have died, have never, never left. Those dead, the dead are not under the earth. They are in the rustling trees. They are in the growing woods. They are in the crying grass. They are in the moaning rocks. The dead are not under the earth.
Those who have died have never, never left. The dead have a pact with the living. They are in the woman's breast. They are in the wailing child. They are with us in our homes. They are with us in the crowd. The dead have a pact with the living. Listen more often to things than to beings. 'Tis the ancestors' breath when the fire's voice is heard. 'Tis the ancestors' breath and the voice of the water.
Words of Love by Christopher Keller.
First of all, thank you all. I'm actually a long way. We were only expecting so many people, so Y'all have to share chicken later. I want to read you a couple words from those who know this will know this. My strength, my son, the star, he will be my resurrection. All the wrong things I did, he'll lead the right direction. Those who know that, it's from Nasir Jones. That meant a lot to me. My son, his name, Nasir, means one who gives victory. In a way, all this kind of means it right now. The strength he gave us, the strength he gives me now to stand in front of you. And the only reason I'm able to do it is because the strength he did give me. My son, when he was born, was not supposed to live out the hour. The hour became days, and the days became weeks. Not only that, once he made it to his year, he needed surgery to repair his heart. Once again, days became weeks, weeks became months. He was in ICU for 3 months, and he made it. He sustained us all, and he's the only reason I'm able to stand in front of you today. The strength that he gave me, that if he can go through that, I am but a piece of this. Me and Keir want to thank all of you. There is but so little time, but everyone in this room means something to me. I look in this crowd, and I know that we are loved, and that is bigger than all of us here. Beauty comes from within, and the beauty that he gave me allowed me to stand up here, and I know I keep saying this, I keep repeating myself, but that's the only thing I can tell you. But I do want to give a special shout out and some love to my Omi, to Adrian Sapp. Adrian Sapp is the person who sustained us during our hardest times. She kept us here every day, no matter what, and even on our darkest days, she always needed him and wanted him by her side. So I'm sorry, Auntie. Your baby's here with us all now. You can't keep him to yourself. He belongs to us. The love, he gave me love, the ability, a sense of happiness, and a sense of peace being around him. The occasional smile and the best nap partner I could ever have. If you know me and Nas, we're on the corner, lying down, we're taking our naps. And we used to do this before his mother and his sister came in, because they were the hype ones. So we had to find a way to get our time in. The point being is that he gave this world the best 3 years he had. He is the best teacher in this world. And if I can give you anything today, take the damn trip. Don't worry about the damn money. The money's coming back. I promise you that money will come back. Take the money, take the trip, do what you do, and do what is best for you. Don't procrastinate. Love hard. That's all you can do. We're not promised any of this. The love we are giving to each other right here in this time is that's all we have, and this is for mom. This is just this moment. This gift given is not yours. And the truth is, as I look into you, I don't feel slighted. My son won't make it, but I don't feel slighted. And I don't see the world as unfair. Acceptance of the blessings in this life should be everyone's goal. I'm a better man today because of my son. The patience I've learned, the unconditional love, and the clear-mindedness and knowledge of self that he's given me cannot be given, is a small price to pay. All often we look forward to the bad and only can see the negative. But looking at the life with grace and humbleness, and gather in gratitude of the gifts. Look forward, but remember, love, blessings of your past, great experiences, memories, no matter how much money you have, the moments you always remember will be the ones you be with your family. Doesn't matter how much that car you have outside, the house you live in, you will always remember the best time with your cousins. This is my ace right here. We don't see each other often. We grew up as a brother before my brother was around. I love him to death, and as I stand here, he's holding me up, because without him right now, I damn guarantee I will fall off this podium. So I'm gonna leave you with one thing. One of my favorites, favorite poet, favorite author, James Baldwin. You think your pain and heartbreak are unprecedented in the history of the world, but then you read. You're not alone, you. And I guarantee we'll be there to pick you up when you need it most. We love you all, and thank you so much.
Now we come to that place in service. I know we all could reflect on the words of his father, how Nasir was his strength. Thank God that he allows us to have people in our lives to give us that strength, or we wouldn't make it. A brother is born for adversity, but a friend loveth at all times. Now we come to the words of comfort to be given us on this day by much grace by the Reverend Darlene Henderson.
Well, we give God praise and we give God thanks. Won't you join me in praising God for his goodness, his grace, and his mercy? And even if you'll join me in a word of prayers, I won't be before you long, heads bowed, hearts humbled. Most gracious and mighty God, our Father, we've come here today, God, to celebrate and to commit to your loving care the joyous and amazing and beautiful spirit of a son, a brother, a grandson, nephew, and friend, our beloved Nasir Christopher Kamal Kelly. Father, we've come not to question you, but to give you glory for allowing us to experience the joy that Nas brought to so many lives. We've come, Father, to show our love, our support, to Kia, to Christopher, to Naima, their entire family and friends gathered here today, to surround them with our love, our prayers, and our faith. In Jesus' mighty and matchless name, we do pray. Let everyone say amen.
Amen.
Well, if you have come here today and you've had the pleasure of knowing Nas, then you know that today indeed is a celebration of life. Why don't you celebrate his life? And without a shadow of a doubt, it's clear that God's hand, as you have heard, as you have seen, what how you will read, that it's beyond a shadow of a doubt that God's hand has been upon him as he continually allowed miracle, miracle upon miracle after miracle to be shown in and through his life. It was a brief life, but we thank God for the life that he has given us. Amen?
Amen.
And as you'll have the opportunity, as Cher, to read and to have viewed, you'll see that even he was given just the 1 week to live, hours to live, as his father has shared, but Nas blessed his mom and dad and sister and family as he steadily surpassed milestone after milestone after milestone. Traveled to monuments that some of us here even haven't seen. Amen. So we give God the glory and praise for that. And we give God most of all glory and praise for a family that ensured that he would be loved and not limited. And Mark 10 tells us in verses 14 through 15, let the children come to me and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of God. And verse 16 even goes on to say, and he took them up in his arms, he laid hands on them, and he blessed them. And if you're here today and you're a believer in Christ, then we know we have every confidence that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And that same Jesus who took the little children in his arms, blessed them on earth, he also has received us into his arms and has blessed him, has welcomed him personally into heaven. Isn't that good news?
Amen.
And so though questions may loom, as has been said, we don't come to question God, but we're thankful for the word of God that provides us some assurance. And Deuteronomy reminds us in the 29th chapter, the 29th verse, that the secret things, they belong to God. We don't know some things. We can't understand everything. We would have loved for Nas to be with us many more years and to bless us with his beautiful smile and joyful spirit, his loving color of orange as we see around the room today. But we're not here today to question again God. But in the midst of our pain, our sorrow, we take great comfort in knowing that Jesus understands our pain. He understands our heartache. And he understands that whenever we find ourselves hurting, not only today, but in the days to come, that we're assured that we can find shelter in our God. We can rely on God. The Bible says that Jesus is touched by the feelings of our infirmities. And Jesus himself said, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. The Bible says that God is the Father of all mercies and the God of all comfort. And we're told that he is the one who comforts us in our tribulation. So not only can we rely on God, but we can also rest in God. In 2 Samuel 12, David feels the same that this family feels here today. In the Bible, it tells us in 2 Samuel, the 12th chapter, that David felt the same sorrow we're feeling. David felt the same pain. And he showed that there are limitations in our humanity. We hurt. We have sorrow. We have pain. But David concluded, just as this father has shared on today, David concluded, in essence, he won't return to me, but I shall go to him. He was acknowledging that God would have the final word. And that is good news. We can rely on God and we can rest on God. But finally, what can we do? We can rejoice in God. Finally, we can rejoice in God. Because God does have the final word. And to the world, to the person who doesn't know Christ, death is the final word. But we have a Savior who conquered death. A Savior who provides eternal life and the hope of the resurrection to all who believe. In speaking of the physical resurrection, Paul said this, as I conclude in 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound and the dead in Christ will be raised. Death has been swallowed up in victory. It says, oh death, where is your sting? Where is your victory? But thanks be to God, it says in verse 57, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. So we come for a solemn reason here today, but we come ultimately to celebrate God. To thank God for Naz's life, for allowing us the measure of time that he was a blessing, not only to this family, but to all the many people gathered here today. So we know that these parents feel a loss today, but we know too that there is a God who is bigger, a God who is greater than our disappointments and our pains, and he will give comfort and strength to this family, to each and everyone here today, as we'll close in a period of celebrating again God's goodness, his grace, his mercy, and the comfort that only we know that. you, God, for being the God of all comfort. Thank you, God, for being with this family to do as only you can do, to comfort them in only ways that you can. Father, we pray that you will allow those who are here today to not just be here for today, but to be here in the days to come, to call and to encourage them, to intercede for them, as we will continually reflect on the many memories, the joyous times, the good times, the glad times, as Father will ultimately give you all of the glory and all of the praise. It is in the name of Jesus we do pray and give thanks. Amen.
Those believe that prayer, praise is powerful. For such a word that we just received, can we give God just a little bit more praise? David said, I bless the Lord at all, and his praise shall continue to be in my mouth. As I say, thank you. You eulogized Nasir in a way that was appropriate for the life of our hero. And I, not knowing him personally, just coming in this atmosphere today, he was a hero. This young man's life has wrecked, made a difference in our lives today. This portion of the service over. Hands of the petitions, come bless you.
The family would like to thank each and every one of you for coming out today. Wrap your loving arms around them. A special thank you to Pastor Ford, Pastor Henderson. We appreciate you coming out today and giving words of encouragement. It seems like an overwhelming amount of support here. So we know in the days to come, when the phone pretty much stopped ringing, if it crossed your mind, whisper a prayer that God will strengthen this family. Family, on behalf of Mr. Willie Watkins and our entire staff, we have a small token of love that we'd like to present to you from us to you as a token of our love and our appreciation. And I heard the pastor say it. You got an angel now. He said 3 years. And I want to assure you that I've been doing this 20-some years. And I've seen some people that have lived 40, 50, and 60 years. Can't bring this many people out. So I want you to know that on a Wednesday morning, 10 o'clock in the morning, we fill the chapel up. That speaks volume of the connection that these parents have, the support that they have. So just keep supporting them. Keep on loving on them. And we do appreciate you. And we thank God for you. We'll be leaving here going directly to Sunrise Memorial Gardens for his final resting place. And we do ask that following us in the procession, we ask that you turn your headlights and your flashes on. And again, thank you so much. At this time, Pastor.
God, I thank you, Lord Jesus, that even